Okay, I have a case. This is an iPhone 7 that cannot be powered up. It's never been repaired before. I'm the first hand, so I'm going to read with power supply first to see what's going on. Inject the wood slowly. Okay, I don't see any back shot, but there's a little leaking. Okay, current is leaking. It shouldn't be raised up like 10 or 20 mA like this. Okay, something is leaking, draining the power. So press the power button. Okay, the board is OPC, which is not UMT. UMT has a lot of problem. Okay. Okay, you see the shot is like goes up and then come down. Every time I press it, see, it's sometimes low, sometimes high. So definitely something short in the boot up circuit. Okay, the power rail boot up. So I should take off the sticker off here and then check with the thermal camera. Okay, because thermal camera can see under this power IC, the main power IC, which area of the spot get heat up. Okay, because let's say this corner, I will just check this corner, what's the line. Okay, usually he will have one section getting the heat, or I can straight jump to my experience, which is measure the capacitor around the NAND. Because they are booting up the NAND, they have a few voltage line, hey, three voltage line. Okay, one of it is the 3.0 that is very easy go short, that will have these symptoms. Okay, he boot up and close now. So I will jump to my experience by remove some of the glue and done the fill of, and then measure those kind of cap. Hopefully it's easy money. Okay. Yep, as I've expected. So this line is full shot. Okay, this cap is responsible for the 3.0. So I will go to iPhone 7 Intel and look for this cap. See, it is the PP3V0 NAND. Okay, 3.0 volt of the NAND. This line, a very high chance this is one of the capacitor shorted. Okay, it is a common problem. So if I use thermal camera to look, okay, I believe this part will heat up. Okay, instant of here. Okay, they're usually not getting heat up in one of the cap in here, unless you are directly put the volt to this line, not from the battery, and then you can see it. Okay, if I come from the battery, the volt come from the battery, usually the power IC heat up and then he drops down, you know, not hitting the actual problem. Okay, I will try with the thermal camera and see which one is the problem. But the problem is we need to keep pressing the power button. So we will need a flex in order to press it and look at behind. And then inject. Okay, about battery level. So looking at the power IC now. So as I say, you press it, that place heat up and then it drops down. There are a few more lines. Okay, even the boost IC is heat up, but I can see there's one of the cap in here. Okay, it's the one that is actual problem, because the power IC and the boost IC, they are the one supply, you know, they can be overdraw the power and then he get heat up. But the capacitor is the actual problem. So now I'm going to pinpoint which capacitor is the problem. There's two cap in there. Turn off the wood and then I clean up. Okay. Okay, so try again. Okay, this is what I'm talking about. Okay? Sometimes it's too fast, you only see the power IC heat up. Okay, too fast. Even the boost IC not heating up. Okay. So actually it is the cable. Okay. If you change to another type of the cable, which is not direct line, he can get more heat. Okay. Or maybe a battery. Okay. So I will try a battery. See, if a battery, it will be constantly heat up, okay, non-stop, and you don't know which one is it, okay, but as I say, usually it's the capacitor, okay. Now, in order to know which one is easy, we are going to use the rosin, okay, and smoke the area there. Right, this will be enough. And then we see after we press the power button which one melted first. Okay, okay, the left one. Immediately unplug. So just remove this cap and the problem will be gone. Activated. Yeah. Another trophy. Okay. And then check with the power supply again. Okay. You know the board might has a little drain issue. Okay. It is about 10 or 15 mA draining. But that's not my main problem. Okay, because I'm gonna fix it until it turn on first. Okay. Press the power button. See, it goes up and then come down. But after it come down, it seems like a little higher. Okay, I need to fix the drain issue, or else any battery you put on, it will drain out really quickly, even if you turn it off. Okay. So I'm gonna take off another sticker. I'm sure the phone can be turned on by now, but it's not enough. We need to see what else need to be fixed now. See, when I plug in the cable, immediately it draw the current. So flip it over. Usually the first thing I suspect is this IC. 2G IC, the network 2G, they are very easily to have this problem. Okay, looking at the thermal camera now, and I'm gonna turn off the wood, light it up again. So nothing wrong on there. So from now, I'm going to use the battery. Battery, make sure it's fully charged. and then look at the board again. I still don't see the heat. Okay. Nothing on the bottom. I'm gonna have to look at the top. Okay, remove this shield and check again.
Weapons activated.
Okay, nothing on the top there. It's still on the 2G IC as I expected. Okay. So how do we know it? Okay, first I'm gonna use the blinking technique. Okay, so you look at that place. See, I do the blinking technique. You will see the 2G IC beneath there. They still have that little different. Okay. See that? If I take off my finger, you will notice, okay, that IC, he got the growing. See, still the 2G IC is the problem, which is this one. Okay, this one is the problem. Let's see again. Okay. Okay, so I will take it off. So before I take it off, now look at the power supply. Okay, this is the problem of draining the battery even the phone is standby or off. Okay, you turn off the phone, it still drain the power away. It draw the current. It's leaking. So now we are fixing this.
Weapons activated.
Okay, check again. So now you look at the current. See, it stays zero before I turn it on, you know. No more drain issue. Now press the power button. Yeah, that's more like it. Okay. Okay, I don't have the passcode. Okay, at least we fixed all the problems. Okay, this is the IC I removed just now. Okay, 77359. Okay, this is the 2G network IC for the iPhone 7 Intel version. I can see a little burn mark in here. So we must need to replace it. I know a lot of people that are not going to replace this. They are not going to install it back. because they might think, 2G IC, okay? I think the customer won't notice anything. Since my area has the 3G and 4G, he's not going to use the 2G. But in Malaysia, we must need to install it, okay? If you already have followed my YouTube channel, last year I already told you, Malaysia has just removed all the 3G cell towers. So means I don't install the IC back. When the owner reaching some places that no 4G, he will get no service.